In today's video, I'll show you how from this old photo I made an amazing 3D parallax effect which looks like a real video. And all you need for this is a Photoshop and Premiere Pro. No plugins, no After Effects. This tutorial will be very simple and basic. I love easy stuff. Hi guys, my name is Pavel, and on this channel I share my tips for video content creators as well as my cinematic stories. I'm sure you've heard about the parallax effect, which is a technique where the static image looks like a video thanks to the micro movements of the background and foreground elements on it. And there are many tutorials on this topic, mainly using Adobe After Effects and third-party plugins that you need to purchase. But of course, there are many ways to do that without spending extra money, and in several cases you'll get even better results by applying the set of basic techniques that I'll share with you right now in my video. So let's then jump into our tutorial. Alright, we are in Photoshop, and as an example I chose this old historical photo, which is a colorized version of this original. And this is not a random photo from the internet. This photo was taken in spring of 1918 in Minsk, my native city Belarus, where I come from, and on 25th of March I celebrated the 103rd anniversary of the proclamation of the independence of the Belarusian National Republic, which was the attempt to create a Belarusian state on the territory unfortunately controlled by the German Imperial Army during World War I. This date is very important for me as well as for many other Belarusians, and this is the main reason why I picked a photo from that period of time. So, the most important thing in creating a really great parallax effect is to have several elements on your image that are located pretty far from each other. In our photo, I can clearly see three elements that I'll be able to separate. The first one is this German soldier, then these two, I believe, German officers, and finally the rest of the image. I will start selecting objects using a quick selection tool and copying the selected area into the new layers afterwards. But before selecting, I will go to the Select and Mask menu to set Feather to 2 in order to have softer edges in the selected area. This tool is very simple. The areas you need, you just select using your mouse. The areas you don't need, you select the same way by holding the Alt or Option key for Mac users on your keyboard. After selecting the objects, just simply right-click and choose Layer via Copy. Let me do that with the officers as well, and then we'll move forward. Alright, we have now three layers – one soldier, two officers, and the rest of the image. If we leave it as it is, we may still get this parallax effect, however, while moving these copied layers, we'll see their originals underneath. And that looks really bad. What we need to do, we need to erase the militaries from this first underneath layer and recreate the environment without these people in the image. Why wouldn't we just cut them, you might think? Well, cutting the objects will not help us, as we will get just the empty space in their place. We need to have this area filled with an image. But this is not a problem for Photoshop. For just a moment, let's hide our layers with people we've cut before, and focus on the back layer where so far we have everything. To not do the same work with selecting the objects, I'll make a selection trick. Hide for a moment the main layer and open the one with the soldier. Choose Object Selection tool and select the man. After we select him, hide this layer back and return to the main layer. Right-click with your mouse on the image and use the option Content Aware Fill. Photoshop will open two windows. On the left, there is our original photo with the selected area that Photoshop is taking into consideration while generating the environment inside the area we've selected. On the right side, we have a preview of how that would look. If you don't want Photoshop to take some areas of the image into consideration, such as people's faces or the elements that are very different from the area behind the soldier, we can just simply deselect it in the left screen by moving the circle and erasing the green area. By default it's green, but you might choose any color from the menu on the right side. Once we are satisfied with the result, click Apply and then OK. Right away, you'll notice an additional layer that will appear on our Layers panel. These are the changes that we've just made. All you need to do is just to press Ctrl or Shift button on your keyboard and select these both layers that we are working on right now. Right-click and choose Merge Layers. The same thing we'll do with these two officers. We select the area, fill it with the environment, merge the layers, and as a result, we have the image without these three people in it. It shouldn't be perfect in case you don't have much movement in your video, but if you have, that would uncover a larger area behind our militaries. So in this case, you would need to paint the area behind them more precisely. For that, you may use a regular brush tool or clone stamp tool to replicate the area in other places. But if your objects have a very good separation from the background, most probably you would not even have to do that. That's it! We have a three layers image, and now we may save our file using a PSD extension, a regular Photoshop file. Let's now create a Premiere Pro project and import our Photoshop file. Let's start a new project and name it Parallax. Alright. When we drag the Photoshop file to our project panel, you'll see several options that we have. I could import it as a sequence right away, but we have just three layers, so I'll choose the option Individual Layers. Hit OK, and you'll notice a new folder that contains three images. Drag the entire folder to your timeline and put them in the exact order we had them in Photoshop. So the closest object to the viewer, in our case it's a German soldier, is on the top. We may rename our layers on any stage of our work. I will do it now to have a better idea what each layer represents. At this point, our sequence is almost square, but I know that I would like to have my video in 4K. I could set my sequence size at the very beginning, but to show you that it can be done at any stage, I will go to Sequence Now, and in the sequence settings, I will set 4K resolution for my project. And to fit the entire screen, at least from the top to the bottom, I will select all layers and from the right click we'll choose the option Scale to the frame size. At this point we've completed the most complex and boring work, now there are only a couple of steps left to make our image actually move. By the way guys, I saw a lot of tutorials where people had just two elements in their sequence, the background and the object in the foreground, and they called it a parallax. Well, technically it may be a parallax, but it doesn't even give you the feeling of dimension. As per me, the real parallax effect you may obtain having minimum three moving elements. And this is exactly what we have in our example. Let's get back to it, by the way. The parallax that kind of makes sense and is pleasant to our eyes is the one that looks more natural. We may use the motion toggles in the effect controls panel to move our objects, but in order to obtain the most natural motion blur in our animation, we will look for a transform effect and drag it into every layer we have. After that, let's set in each of our three effects the shutter angle to 180 degrees. The higher the value in the shutter is, the more motion blur you'll get. If your objects are not moving fast, then 180 should be more than enough. Now, let's go to the very first frame of our composition and put the marks for the starting position and scale for all three layers. Since our movement starts simultaneously, all three layers have starting points at the same point in time. I don't think we'll need the entire length of our layers for this effect. It will be enough to have around 3-4 seconds only. So I will adjust the length of my layers, and afterwards we'll move to the very last frame of my composition. Since the soldier is the closest object to the viewer, I will start with him. I will be increasing his scale and moving his position until he disappears from the screen and becomes big enough, giving the impression of real motion towards him. Alright, these values now, and I'm talking mainly about the scale, is our reference now. All other layers that are located farther than our soldier cannot have the scale value equal or higher than our soldier. And that is one of the mistakes a lot of creators do. They make the motion the way that the background becomes larger in scale than the objects in the foreground, and that looks so unnatural. There are exceptions, of course, if someone wants to simulate a Vertigo effect, but for natural motion, never make background objects move faster than the ones you have in the foreground. So let's then move our officers closer, but not so close as we did with the soldier. As you can see, the end scale of our officers is much smaller than the soldiers, but the motion itself looks much more natural for us despite such a huge difference in scale. The last layer obviously will have even less motion, so the end scale of it I will set for around 150-ish and change its position a little bit down. I will additionally add ease out and ease in effect in each layer to have smooth start and end. And additionally, I will add blurriness to my background, so once the foreground objects are getting closer to the viewer, the background image is getting more and more blurry. In the Effects tab, find the effect called Fast Blur and drag it to the background layer. The beginning of our blur effect will be obviously set to 0, and let's finish it on, let's say, 30. I will also make this transition smooth, setting the starting and ending points to ease out, ease in accordingly. And I'll also check the option Repeat Edge Pixels to have the entire image blurred without artifacts on its edges. Now it looks much better. Let's select all our layers, right-click and choose Nest to have our composition in one sequence. Hit OK, find again the transform effect, drag it to our sequence, and now I'll show you a couple of final tricks to make our parallax just perfect. To make our video free of black bars on the sides, I will increase the scale of the image at the starting point to cover 100% of the screen. Right away, I will increase the shutter angle to 180 degrees. And now, to give our video more handheld effect, I will be moving our video slightly up and down, left and right, every quarter of a second. Of course, more or less, there is no precision needed, we just want to add a little bit more of dynamics. That's it! Done! I have just transformed an old static photo into an amazing 3D parallax effect using just two tools, Photoshop and Premiere Pro, without any plugins. Doesn't it look fantastic? I'm pretty sure if you got to the end of this video, you'll have no issues with creating your own parallax animation. But if you need to go back and check some particular actions in Photoshop or Premiere Pro, I created the chapters, so it will be much easier to navigate through this tutorial. If it was helpful, like this video and share your thoughts in the comments section, I'll be happy to hear from you. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that yet, check out my Instagram for even more awesome content. Love you guys and see you in the next one. Cheers!